Well, good morning to you and welcome to the International Church of Shanghai. I think we have an interesting Sunday because most of you or most of our brothers and sisters are working. But for those of you who have come today, fantastic, good to see you. There are a couple of announcements to make before we get started. First, we're a multi-denominational church. We're open only to holders of foreign passports or foreign permanent residence holders only. So please, you would have shown your passports on the way in, and you'll have to do it every week. So thank you for your patience there. There's an overflow room on the third floor if you're coming in with children and you want to be close to Kids Church on the third floor. There's a holding area for you. At the same time, if you've driven here today, a car parking coupon is always a blessing given the rates that we experience in Shanghai. And also, if you're having your cell group lunches at the church or dinners, there's a discount for members. Again, you can inquire at the table outside. We are very, very blessed to have Reverend Wee with us, not only for this Sunday. He's also teaching a discipleship seminar, which is happening on the 1st of July. And I'll sign up first, a bit of FOMO for you here, open for the first 50 people. It's gonna be simultaneous Chinese translation. So, and we also have separate kids activities. So feel free to bring your children along. They'll be well looked after as you're ministered to. And I think there's a new update time of 10 a.m. I don't think it's to suit Reverend Wee's breakfast. I think it's just to make sure that everyone can come. So it's 10 a.m. indeed. And the weekly bulletin to follow the activities in this church, it's now digital as well. So that was a matter of time, isn't it? So there's a paper copy would have gone on the way in. But there is also a digital version. So if we look at the cell groups, again, I say every Sunday when I'm on duty, if you're not in the cell group, please get into one. Look at your neighbor and give them that weird look. Are you in a cell group? You need to be in one. So the first cell group that we want to spotlight is Precious Gold. Families with teenagers and singles that meet on Sunday after the first service. Near the Gubei area. You can see that we are many different times, we're living in different groups. Fantastic to see them all in red and enjoying themselves in fellowship. Also an English cell group, Living Grace. And they meet in a group of married couples with children on Friday. So another flexible time there from 8 p.m. near the Hongqiao area. So again, if that time suits, please join them. At the same time, we are setting up a new cell group for families with young children that meet on Saturday. Please talk to the Connect booth outside for more information. So again, please, if you're not part of a cell group, please join one. They're usually friendly, but lots of good food. Okay, and if you're traveling to Singapore, we have a sister church there. We call ICS Singapore or ICSG. We all love our acronyms in Singapore, ICSG. So if you're there, they're not too far from where you are on Orchard Road, I'm sure. So please make your way down to see our sister church if you're on business or indeed you are traveling to Singapore. Right, so the exciting time now to meet newcomers. If you're a newcomer today and it's your first time in ICS, would you raise your hand? Anyone that's new today, or all the newcomers have gone to work, I think. With anyone here today? No, I won't tell your boss that you're here. Good. Now, if you have obviously friends who are foreign passport holders, they're more than welcome to join us any Sunday. And farewells, I think we saw a couple of families last week going back home, but if there's anyone here that's leaving us and you've worshipped for us for more than 6 months, anyone at all? No, well, that makes it very simple for me. Well, I want to pray before we get worship underway. All right, as the worship team plugs up, we just want to pray and give you honor and prepare our hearts for worship. Father God, we give you all praise, Lord. We honor you, Father God, and even though we're in a hall of a few people, it don't matter. We're here to worship you and an audience of one. We, Father, that this morning as we declare, Father, as we exalt you, Make yourself real to us, Lord. We believe and we believe and we believe, Father God, that you're the Son of God, that you died for us, that you came to save us from eternal damnation. We believe. We believe, Father God. We believe. So we thank you in the name of Jesus, Father, in a time of worship, that we can connect with you. I pray for the worship team as they lead us, Father God, they'll get lost in worship. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Oh, give life. You are love, light to the darkness. You give hope, you restore, bring heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. See again, you give life. You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness. You give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise. We pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour. Bow before
We lift your name up. Father God, thank you for this privilege. We can come before your presence and worship you, and worship you alone, Father God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Presence is here today, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, as you minister to every heart today, Father. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, everyone said amen.
Amen.
Amen. Great. As we enter a time of tithes and offerings, the hospitality team is passing the offering bag around. I want to thank you for all your contributions to the church, and God loves a cheerful giver. If you're new with us today, and just feel free to pass the offering bag by you. There's no obligation whatsoever. If you're that way inclined, then please scan the QR codes that you have on the screen right now. I'll just leave it there for a moment while you make the scan. Thank you very much again for your tithes. As you know, that Pastor Daniel and his family are back in Singapore for the summer break. He'll be away for 3 weeks. And what a privilege it is to have an old friend. Many of you who remember Dr. Wee Boon Hup, he's been here before, as I remembered a photo I had with him and Catherine in August the 2nd, 2019. So it's been a little while, but we're so happy to see them again. Reverend Wee served as a minister in the Methodist Church of Singapore for 39 years. And subsequently, he was the bishop of the Methodist Church when he was conferred a bishop emeritus upon his retirement in 2016. So without any further ado, let's give a warm Shanghai welcome to Reverend Wee.
Good morning. Brothers and sisters in Christ, it's good to be back in Shanghai after so many years. The last time I think we were here was in 2019. So my wife and I always look back to coming to Shanghai and explore not just Shanghai, from here to other parts of China as well. And so we are very grateful to Pastor Daniel for inviting us to be here, and again to be in your presence, to fellowship with you, to worship the Lord together. It's a joy. Oh, sorry.
Can you hear me? Yeah. 早上好，大家。嗯，谢，嗯，谢谢，嗯，丹尼尔牧师，邀请我这次来跟大家一起分享信息。嗯，我和我的太太非常高兴来到上海。我们上一次来与大家分享信息见面的时候是2019年，所以我们这次会在上海探索一些地方，然后到从上海到别的地方去看一看。
Our scripture passage for this morning is taken from Jeremiah chapter 1, verses 1 to 12.
今天早上我的经文分享的经文是耶利米书的1章1到12节。
The text is not on the screen, so this is to encourage you to flip over your paper Bible or your digital Bible and follow the reading. I will read first in English, and then Yue He will read it in Chinese.
今天早上我要读的经文不在这个投影仪上，所以呢，我会就是如果你要有纸质的圣经，或者你有电脑上的这个app，你可以打开，我们一起来读耶利米书一章1到12节。我会读英文，然后翻译会读中文。That's
very good. This is a surprise. So since it's on the screen, let's all read it together aloud, shall we? We seldom do that, I believe, in many churches. So let's read that aloud together, only 12 verses, beginning. The words of Jeremiah, the son of Hilkiah, one of the priests who were in Anathoth, in the land of Benjamin, to whom the word of the Lord came in the days of Josiah, the son of Ammon, king of Judah, in the 13th year of his reign. It also came in the days of Jehoiakim, the son of Josiah, king of Judah, and until the end of the 11th year of Zedekiah, the son of Josiah, king of Judah, until the captivity of Jerusalem in the 5th month. Now the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you, and before you were born, I consecrated you. I appointed you a prophet to the nations. Then I said, Ah, Lord God, behold, I do not know how to speak. But the Lord said to me, Do not say, I am only a youth, for to all to whom I send you, you shall go and do whatever I command you. You shall speak. Do not be afraid of them, for I am with you to deliver you, declares the Lord. Then the Lord put his hand and touched my mouth, and the Lord said to me, Behold, I have put words in your mouth. See, I have set you this day over nations and over kingdoms to pluck up and to break down, to destroy and to overthrow, to build and to plant, And the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Jeremiah, what do you see? And I said, I see an almond branch. Then the Lord said to me, You have seen well, for I am watching over my word to perform it.
刚才牧师说，就是我们今天有一个，大家最后还是把这个放在投影仪上了，所以大家开声读圣经，这是很多教会现在没有机会做到的事情。那我现在读中文，耶利米书一章一到十二节，便雅悯地亚拿突城的祭司中，希勒家的儿子耶利米的话记在下面。第二节，犹大王亚门的儿子约西亚。在位十三年，耶和华的话临到耶利米。如果你读中文的话，也可以跟我一起大声读出来哈。从犹大王约西亚的儿子约雅敬在位的时候，直到犹大王约西亚的儿子西底家在位的末年，就是十一年五月间，耶路撒冷人被掳的时候，耶和华的话也常临到耶利米。耶利米说：“耶和华的话临到我说，我未将你造在腹中，我已晓得你。”你未出母胎，我已分别你为圣，我已派你做列国的先知。我就说，主耶和华啊，我不知怎样说，因为我是年幼的。耶和华对我说，你不要说我是年幼的，因为我差遣你到谁那里去，你都要去。我吩咐你说什么话，你都要说。第十节，你惧怕他们，因为我与你同在，要拯救你，这是耶和华说的。于是耶和华伸手按我的口，对我说：“我已将刚刚说的话传给你。看哪，我今日立你在列邦列国之上，为要施行、拔出、拆毁、毁坏、倾覆，又要建立、栽植。”耶和华的话又临到我说：“耶利米，你看见什么？”我说：“我看见一根杏树枝。”耶和华对我说：“你看得不错。”因为我留意保守我的话，使得成就。
There are times in our lives when God has to grab our attention.
在我们的生活中，有时候上帝必须吸引我们的注意力。
In the Bible, we read of a few examples.
在圣经里面，我们看到几个例子。
You think about Moses.
想到摩西的例子。
He was running away from his people.
他逃离远离他的百姓。
In a way, he was also running from God.
所以在某种程度上，他也是逃离上帝。
And then he was startled when God spoke to him through a burning bush.
所以在一个火燃着的荆棘中，上帝突然出现在他面前跟他讲话的时候，他大吃一惊。
And then there's someone like Paul.
我们也想到保罗的例子。
He was running towards his people.
他跑向他的百姓。
And he was persecuting his own people who had become Christians.
他迫害那些成为基督徒的那些人。
And then he met the Lord on the road to Damascus with a bright shining, and God spoke to him through in a bright shining light.
所以他在大马士的路上的时候，他遇到了上帝。上帝在一个大光中向他显现，跟他说话。
And then there's someone like Jeremiah.
然后我们看到像耶利米这样的人。
And Jeremiah is seldom someone that we study in terms of his personal life.
我们在教会里这种很少是专门去学习像耶利米他的一个个人的生活。
But Jeremiah is like many of us.
可是耶利米就像我们中的很多人一样。
He was in the Lord's service.
他是服侍主的。
He was faithfully serving the Lord in the temple.
他是非常忠心的，在殿里面服侍主的。
And he's just doing his own Christian, so-called, you know, believer's duty.
他每天就是这样的尽职尽责的做他每天的这个职责，也就是我们所说的基督徒的这个职责。
I assume that many of us are like that.
我想我们中间很多人也是这样的。
We are trying to be faithful to the Lord.
我们尽量的想争取能够忠心的来服侍主。
We're doing our daily spiritual disciplines.
我们做我们每天需要的这个属灵操练。
We do the right Christian things in our lives.
我们好像在生活中做的都是一些正确的基督徒应该做的事情。
And maybe because we do it so well,
可能因为我们做得很好。
We are living in our comfort zones.
所以我们好像就落在了一个安乐圈或者舒适圈里面。
And so God has to also grab our attention.
所以这个时候，上帝也要吸引我们的注意力。
The slide before this.
在这之前的一片投影片。
Yeah, this is a verse in 2 Chronicles 16:9. The eyes of the Lord run to and fro throughout the earth to give strong support to those whose heart is blameless towards Him.
我们最看到的这段经文是历代志下16章9节的第一部分。耶和华的眼目遍察全地，要显大能，帮助向他心存诚实的人。
You see, God's eyes roam through the earth.And then he's looking for someone whose heart is strongly in him.
所以我们看到当上帝的眼目遍察四处的时候，他在寻找一个人，这个人的心能够非常强烈的，这个人的心能够心意是他的心意。
Something out of the ordinary happens.
在一个不寻常的事情发生了。
You see, in most of our lives, we believe that we are faithful and we are looking and gazing at the Lord.
我们大多数时间，我们都觉得我们好像，好像很有信心。然后呢，我们都是我们的眼光都凝视在神的身上，注视在神的身上。
But what if God is looking back at us?
但是你有没有想过，当主回望我们的时候是怎么样一回事
？And then He has a calling upon our lives.
他对我们有一个呼召，对我们的生命有个呼召。
And so what happens when God looks back at us?
所以当神回望我们的时候会发生什么呢
?The next slide.
下一片投影片。
Why does God want to grab attention of people like us?
为什么上帝要吸引我们这些人的注意力呢
?That's because something big is going to happen in our lives.
因为会有一件很大的事情在我们的生命中发生。
It may not be as big so that it will be world shaking.
可能不是这种震撼全世界的这种很大的事情。
But it will be big in the sense that it's going to shake our lives.
但是它可能会震动我们的生命的这种大事。
Jeremiah was a young priest.
耶利米是一个年轻的祭司。
He was probably in his early 20s.
他大概是二十岁出头。
And he protested.
他当初就抗议。
When God spoke to him and called him.
当上帝与他说话的时候，他抗议。
And he said, Lord, I'm too young.
他说主啊，我还很年轻。
But we read that the word of the Lord came to him.
可是我们读到圣经里说，主耶和华的话临到他。
When that expression is used, it normally means the word of the Lord comes to us. It means that the person where the word comes to must have been in a position where he would know it is the word of the Lord.
我们当我们用这种表达方式，就是耶和华的话临到某人的时候，我们常常是指当这个接受耶和华话的这个人，他处于一个某一个地方，某一个姿势。他很清楚肯定地知道这个话是从耶和华来的。
Jeremiah was faithfully doing his role as a priest in the temple.
当初耶利米在在殿里面就是说非常尽心尽职尽责的忠心的服侍主。
See, when God grabs our attention, it does not necessarily mean that we have been straying away, maybe like in Moses. It could simply mean that he has something he wants us to do.
所以当上帝要来吸引我们注意力的时候他并不真正的是说我们一定是就远离他了偏离他了就像我刚才说的摩西的例子但是他可能在我们生命中有一件事情要我们去做
It simply means that God is looking at us and he wants to draw us closer to him for something bigger that he has in store for us
他可能仅仅的是表示上帝在注视着我们 他希望能够吸引我们能亲近他然后他有一件大事要我们来做
And so it is to bring us into something bigger
他是把我们带到一件更大的事情中间
If we are very happy where we are in our Christian life, it's very often also that we're quick to reject when we find that God has called us to something bigger than ourselves.
如果我们现在在我们的基督徒生活中感到很安适、很安宁的话、很舒适的话，那么如果上帝要把我们呼召到一个更大的地方的时候，我们的第一个反应可能就是我们会拒绝。
We may have settled into a very comfortable life.
可能我们已经很习惯了一个非常舒服的生活。
Nobody likes major changes.
没有人希望有变化。
For Jeremiah, his excuse was that he was too young.
耶利米的借口是他太年轻了。
For some of us, maybe, if I look at this crowd, some of us may think we're too old.
对于我们其他人来说，我们的借口，如果我看一看我们在座的这些人，可能有些人借口说，我的年纪太大了。
For others, we may think that, well, Lord, when I'm not trained.
有些人可能说，哎呦，我受的装备还不够哦。
Or I have family commitments.
或者是我要履行家庭的责任。
Or I have a contract with a company, with some organization that I simply cannot break.
或者是我现在在受一个与一个组织或者一个公司的一个合同的约束，所以我没有办法去毁约。
But God is calling us to step up.
可是当神让我们走出这一步，或者是付诸实践。
It also involves a stepping out of our comfort zone.
也说明我们要走出来，出我们的这个安乐圈。
And so it will involve uncertainty, some risk, and of course, fear.
所以我们一旦要走出这一步，或者是采取行动的时候，都会涉及一定的不确定性、恐惧，而且和风险。
Jeremiah was called from a simple life of an ordinary priest into something big, not only to shake Israel, the Israelites, but to shake the geopolitics of the whole region as well.
所以耶利米当初是从一个非常简单的一个生活，一个很普通的生活，普通的人，神把他呼召出做一件非常大的事情，这个事情能够震动当初以色列，也能够震动当初的这个。 地理和政治的这个气氛。
Jeremiah lived at the same time as King Josiah.
耶利米是与当初一个叫约西亚王，他们俩是在一个同一时代的人。
Their lives overlap.
他们的生命是有overlap.
Overlap.
重叠的，对。
Yeah, so for those of us who know a little bit about the kings of the Old Testament, Josiah was a reforming king.
那些你们中可能有些人对旧约的这些王感到很熟悉。谈到约西亚王的时候，我们知道他是一个大改革家，是个国王。We
read that the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah in the 13th year of the reign of King Josiah.
所以我们在这里面读到是在约西亚王执政13年的时候，耶和华的话临到了耶利米。That
was before Josiah started his reformation.
那是在约西亚王开始他的改革之前。So
Jeremiah's call preceded Josiah's attempts at reviving the life, the spiritual life of the people in Israel.
所以耶利米的这个蒙召是先于约西亚的改革，先于他想恢复或者复兴这个以色列的这个属灵的生活。Jeremiah
lived after the two sons of Josiah, and even during the time of the exile.
所以说在耶利米在那个约西亚王他的两个儿子继承他的王位以后。 就是耶利米活得很长，他能够在他们两个儿子继任之后，他还是活着，一直到他们被放逐到，就以色列人被放逐出去的时候，他还是活着。And
therefore, Jeremiah, as the priest, lived through the reformation of the temple that Josiah instituted.
所以，作为一个祭司，耶利米当初他活得很长，他一直。 他一直亲眼经历了这个约西亚王的当初在就是复兴这个圣殿敬拜的这一他目睹了一切的事情。
But if you were to read the book of Jeremiah, which is very long,
如果你要想读耶利米书的话，这是一本非常长的书。
You will find that Jeremiah, having survived Josiah, did not have a single mention of the Reformation brought about by Josiah.
你会发现在耶利米在他的写的书耶利米书里面，他虽然活得比约西亚王要长，他也目睹了这一切，他却在里面一个字都没有提到约西亚王所做的这种宗教改革。
See, King Josiah's reformation had to do with temple worship, the institutional change of the church, of the temple.
所以当初约西亚王所做的事情是他想复兴以色列的这个殿里面的这些敬拜，那么这是一个宗教型一个性质的改革，也是一个制度性的改革。
But we all know that outside changes will not change what is needed inside.
我们都知道外部的改变没有办法改变人的内心。
And so Jeremiah was called to a bigger challenge than what Josiah had to do for all of Israel.
所以在某种程度上来说，耶利米他这个呼召是有一个更深层次的一个呼召，因为他要做到约西亚王没有办法做到的一个改革，人心的改革。
And this was what the Lord wanted Jeremiah to do. We find this in Jeremiah 31, where the Lord said, For this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, declare the Lord. I will put my law within them, and I will write it on their hearts.And I will be their God, and they shall be my people. And no longer shall each one teach his neighbor and each his brother, saying, Know the Lord. For they shall all know me, from the least of them to the greatest, declares the Lord. And I will forgive their iniquity, and I will remember their sin no more.
所以在耶利米书31章的33节到34节主告诉耶利米他应该做些什么。三十三节，耶和华说：“那些日子以后，我与以色列家所立的约乃是这样：我要将我的律法放在他们里面，写在他们心上；我要做他们的神，他们要做我的子民。”三十四节，他们个人不再教导自己邻舍和自己弟兄说：“你该认识耶和华，因为他们从最小的到至大的都必认识我。我要赦免他们的罪孽，不再纪念他们的罪恶。”这是耶和华说的。
So Jeremiah's call was, in effect, you can say, was earth-shaking.
所以在某种程度上，这个上帝给耶利米的这个呼召是一个震动大地的呼召。
It was how God was going to change the human heart.
这是上帝是如何要改变人的内心。
Now, you may not have the same experience as Jeremiah.
你可能没有和耶利米相似的经历。
God's call upon you may not be world-shaking.
上帝对你的呼召可能不是像他那样的，是一个震动天地的一个呼召。
But whenever God calls,
但是每当上帝呼召的时候
，is going to shake us in some ways.
他会在某种程度上震动我们这个人。
But the beautiful thing about it when God calls is that.He assures us with his calling.
但是有一件美好的事，就是每当神呼召我们的时候，他一定会做一些保证，让我们来放心。
And so, together with the call on Jeremiah's life, God gave Jeremiah a few assurances.
所以主不当是呼召了耶利米，他还同时给了他。几个保证让他能放心。
The first assurance from God was to Jeremiah, "I know you."
第一件事，主告诉耶利米，的这个保证是
，I knew you.
我认识你。
I knew you even before you were born.
你还没有出生之前，我就认识你。
And the Lord was trying to tell Jeremiah, "What I'm asking you to do now was something I had planned from you right from the very beginning when you were still in your mother's womb."
所以主现在想跟他讲的话就是，我现在想让你做的事情，其实在我还在你还没有在母腹成型的时候，我就已经计划好了要你呼召你做这件事情。
An assurance like that is not meant to scare you.
这种保证或者这种让他放心的事情，并不是让我们害怕。
An assurance like that is meant to tell you, I know you and I love you.
这种保证是想告诉我们，我知道你，我晓得你，我爱你。
The second thing that God assured Jeremiah about was that I consecrated you even before you were born.
第二件事，上帝想要耶利米确信的保证是，他说我你还没有出母胎之前，我就已经分别为圣。
It simply means that God had set aside Jeremiah even before he was born.
他只是说在耶利米还没有出生之前，上帝就把他已经把他分别为圣。
That makes us think about ourselves, right?
那我们会想起我们自己，对吗？
Are we in the place where God has set aside for us in our lives before we were born?
我们现在是不是正处在一个地方，就是我们还没有在母腹胎，还没有成胎之前，上帝就已经计划，然后让我们做的事情，在这个位置呢？
And the third thing that God assured Jeremiah of was that God was going to put His words in the mouth of Jeremiah.
第三件事情，上帝要保证的是，上帝要把他的话传给耶利米，并且放在耶利米的嘴里。
For someone raised in the priestly family, Jeremiah would have been very familiar with the book of the laws of Moses.
作为在祭司家庭长大的人来说，耶利米是应该非常熟悉从摩西传下来的律法书。
But here God was going to speak to him personally rather than through the words of Moses.
可是在这里面，上帝选择亲自跟他说话，而不是通过摩西的律法书来跟他说话。
So when God calls you, if and when God calls you, He will assure you.
当主呼召你的时候，如果主呼召你的时候，或者他当他呼召你的时候，他一定会向你做出保证，让你放心的。
That was my experience.
那是我自己的亲身经历。
When I understood God was calling me into the pastoral ministry, God assured me.
当我知道上帝呼召我去做牧师这个事工的时候，上帝给了我保证。
I had already been working after graduating from university for 4 years.
我大学毕业的以后已经工作了四年。
And when I told my widowed mother that I was going to be a Methodist pastor, you know what was the first question she asked me?
当我告诉我这个守寡的母亲说，我已经被神呼召要去做一个理工为理工会的这个牧师的时候，你知道我的妈妈的反应是什么吗
？How much are they going to pay you？
你的工资是多少
？And so, of course, I didn't check the salary before entering, right? So I had to take some time to pray, and the Lord spoke to me and assured me.
所以 当然 我就进入这个牧师这个事工的之前，我是从来不知道，也从来没有查过当初工资是多少。所以呢，我就放出一些时间开始祷告。在我祷告的时候，主确实是向我做出保证，并且让我放心。
And the promise of the Lord came in Joshua chapter 1 verse 8.
主的应许是在哪里呢？主通过了约书亚书一章八节跟我说话。
This book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth, but you shall meditate on it day and night, and do everything to do it, everything, observe everything that is written in it, so that will make your way prosperous, and you will find good success.
约书亚书一章八节大概是这样说的：这律法书不可离开你的口，总要昼夜思想，好使你谨守遵行这书上所写的一切话。如此，你的道路就可以亨通，凡事顺利。
And I can tell you, after 40 years in the ministry, that promise is more than 100% fulfilled.
那我可以有把握的告诉你，在我在这个牧师这个事工里服侍了四十年之久，我告诉你，上帝的这个应许，它不但完全实现，而超过100%的实现。
And so when God calls, He also not just assures us, but He assures us with promises. He gives us promises.
所以当上帝他呼召我们的时候，他不单是就是保证，或者是让我们放心，他还用他的应许来向我们做保证，让我们放心。
So when the word of the Lord comes to you,
所以当耶和华我主耶和华的话临到你的时候，
it's about God charting a direction in your life that may have impact upon many other lives.
他可能在你的生命中制定了一个方向，然后让你的这个生命能够影响其他的人的生命。
To a prophet like Jeremiah, It usually has to do with something that God is going to do.
对于耶利米的这个先知来说，上帝的话，应该是讲他想要耶利米这个先知想要他做一些什么。
It's about declaring God's plans and purposes.
就是要向大家宣告上帝的计划，上帝的目的。
To others like us today, he may call us to be apostolic in the sense that he's sending us out as evangelists and others as pastors and teachers.
对我们其他人来说，他可能是像当初把这些使徒差遣出去一样，把我们也差遣出去，当作传福音的人，或者当牧师，或者去当这个教导神的话的人。
Or he may send us out to be salt and light in the marketplace.In our families and in our communities.
或者是他可能把我们送到职场，把我们送到家庭里，或者是在送到我们的社区，成为上帝的盐和光。
So God gave Jeremiah two crucial promises to ground him at the start of his ministry.
所以上帝在耶利米开始侍奉的时候，给了他两个至关重要的这个应许，让他能够在开始侍奉的时候能站稳脚跟。
So first promise was.I will be with you. I am with you to deliver you.
那他第一个应许给耶利米是：我必与你同在，拯救你。
How far would God go to deliver Jeremiah?
那上帝为了拯救耶利米，他大概画出了他会为耶利米付出多少代价呢？
If we read further down in chapter 1, we hear the Lord telling Jeremiah with his words, "Behold, I make you this day a fortified city."An iron pillar and bronze walls against the whole land, against the kings of Judah, its officials, its priests, and people of the land. They will fight against you, but they shall not prevail against you, for I am with you, declares the Lord, to deliver you.
如果你能读到耶利米书一章十八节到十九节，说到十八节，看呐，我今日使你成为坚城、铁柱、铜墙，与全地和犹大的君王、首领、祭司，并地上的众民反对。十九节，他们要攻击你，却不能胜你，因为我与你同在，要拯救你。这是耶和华说的。
And so, God's promise was deliverance. Should Jeremiah ever come into a very difficult situation?
所以，上帝对耶利米的应许是：如果耶利米遇到一个很困难的时候，那么他要知道他与他同在，并且会拯救他。
The second promise that God gave Jeremiah was, I am watching over my word to perform it.
上帝给耶利米的第二个应许是，我留意保守我的话，使它成就。
That means simply that the Lord will do what he says he will do.
这里说的什么意思呢？就是说，主说什么，他就会做什么。
All that prophet Jeremiah had to do was to say the words, and God would give him to declare, and the Lord himself...would be the power, would be the agent to make those words come true.
所以耶利米所应该做的是什么呢？就是上帝赐给了他的话，他就把上帝的话说出去，向百姓宣告。所以上帝是他的力量，上帝也是他的代表，让他能把这些话传讲出去。
Say the words I give you, leave the consequences to me.
你就说我给你的话，然后其他的后果交给我。
So when God calls,
所以当上帝呼召的时候
it would be not too much of you to ask him to give you some assurances with promises for what he's telling you to do.
所以当上帝呼召你的时候，你不要觉得不好意思，好像问上帝说，你能不能做给我做一些保证啊，给我一些应许啊，好像这对他来说太多的事情，上帝可以做的。
So when God calls,He assures us and he promises us. That's God's follow through of his call upon our lives.
所以当上帝呼召我们的时候，他会给我们一些保证，然后会用应许给我们一些保证，让我们放心。这是他跟进他的计划的一部分。
But what about us? What is the follow through that we need to take when God calls us in our lives?
对于我们来说，那是怎么一回事呢？当上帝呼召我们的时候，我们应该怎么样做来跟进上帝对我们的呼召呢？
How should we respond?
我们应该怎样回应上帝呢？
The thing to note here when we read Jeremiah was that we never hear Jeremiah saying anything to the Lord like, Lord, I submit.
这个耶利米这个例子是很好玩的一件事情，就是我们从来没有在这些描述里圣经的这些叙述里面看到耶利米说，哦，上帝，我顺服你的一切的旨意。
Jeremiah just flowed along with what the Lord was doing through him.
耶利米只是就是不管上帝在他身上做什么，他就顺应上帝所做的一切。
You see, it would be foolishness to do anything else, right?
如果他要做别的事情，那将是很愚蠢的一件事情，不是吗？
If God calls you, you can reject.
如果上帝呼召你的时候，你可以不做的，你可以拒绝他的。
When you reject, God looks for someone else.
当你拒绝了上帝的时候，他会去找另外一个人来去呼召他。
There may be consequences for your rejection.
你这样的拒绝可能会有后果。
But you are missing out on some big things that God wants to do through you and in your life.
可能你就会错过了上帝要在你生活中做一件很大事情的一个机会。
And so, without saying it, Jeremiah was actually submitting and flowing along with what God was doing.
虽然耶利米的嘴巴里没有说，哦，我顺服你的旨意，但是耶利米就是还是，就是顺应上帝要做的一切的事情，他就一步一步的做下去。
You see, we can reject like Jonah.
我们可以和约拿像约拿一样的去拒绝上帝对我们的呼召。
When God asked him to go this way, he went the other way.
当上帝让他去这边的时候，他选择去那一边。
But there were consequences for him.
可是他是有后果的哦。
Even after he was forced to change his mind, he was still resentful, but he flowed along with what God was doing anyway.
可是之后他是被强迫改变他的主意的时候，他心里还是有很多不愿意的，但是呢，他还是顺应着这个上帝的计划继续做下去了。
Jonah was a reluctant prophet.
所以在某种程度来说，约拿是一个很不情愿的先知。
But he was still a prophet.
但是他还是一个先知。
Jeremiah was a willing prophet.
耶利米是一个情愿的，他愿意听上帝话的先知。
But the next thing to note was that when God calls, we must be prepared to know that it is not going to be pain-free.
还另外一件事情我们想要学习的就是当上帝呼召我们的时候，我们不要就认为因为我们响应了上帝的呼召，所以我们剩下的生活就是会与痛苦绝缘的。
You remember the promise that God gave to Jeremiah?I am with you to deliver you.
你记得上帝给耶利米的应许吗？他说：“我和你同在，我要救赎你。”
That should not, make us think that Jeremiah didn't suffer any pain.
这个不会说，那么耶利米以后就没有痛苦了。
He was, tortured in a sense. He was put in a dungeon, and so he was not pain-free for Jeremiah.
他在很多程度上他是受了折磨，他被放在地狱里，地牢里面囚禁了很久，所以呢，对于耶利米来说，他蒙召以后他的生活是很痛苦的。
We need to read the promises God gives us very carefully.
我们应该很仔细地看上帝给我们的应许。
God promised Jeremiah, I am here, I am with you to deliver you.
上帝对耶利米的应许是：我在这儿，我和你同在，我会救赎你。
If you don't suffer pain, there's nothing to deliver you from.
如果没有痛苦的话，那么他要从什么地方来救赎他，来拯救他呢？
So the call for God, the promise of God to deliver us means simply that He will set us free. But before the freedom comes, there may be some pain.
所以虽然上帝会跟我们说我会拯救你，但是我们还是有一定的痛苦的这个过程，之后他才会把我们就是给我们自由，因为自由 是从痛苦来的自由，不再受苦。
God did deliver Jeremiah.
上帝确实救赎了拯救了耶利米。
But only after he went through a time of suffering.
可是那是当他受了一段时间的苦之后。
You see, you need to know the kind of message that Jeremiah preached.
所以你应该清楚耶利米他传讲的宣告的信息是什么样的信息。
Jeremiah preached against the existing political and religious institutions of his time.
耶利米当初宣讲的信息是他谴责当时的政治制度和当时的这个宗教制度。
He preached at least 10 messages in the book, accusing Israel of breaking God's covenant.
在耶利米书这部书里面，他传讲了至少十篇的信息，是指责以色列人违背了上帝跟他们立的约。
He was challenged by someone who was a false prophet and called Jeremiah a false prophet.
他遭遇了一个当初一个假先知的挑战和对峙，那个人自以为是先知。
He was imprisoned in a dungeon for a long time.
他在地牢里面被囚禁很久，长时间囚禁。
Before that, he was beaten, he was mocked, he was put in the stocks.
在那之前，他遭受了殴打，遭受了人的嬉笑，和他被带上了枷锁。
And Jeremiah did not take this lying down. Of course, he complained to the Lord.
当然了，耶利米的反应是什么？他就跟主来抱怨。
You want to know what was his complaint?
你想知道他抱怨的内容是什么吗
？There was a whole book in the Bible for you to know to read. It's called the Lamentations.
那有专门的圣经里专门有一本书是写这个的，是叫做耶利米哀书，哀歌。
It's a very long complaint, so you can read it.
这个很长很长的抱怨啊，你回家可以去自己读读。
But it was while he was in isolation that he had time to reflect.
但是这是在耶利米与世隔绝的时候，他这个时候才有时间去反思。
It was the time of suffering that tested him to the point where he realized who he really was and who God really was to him.
那么他当初经受了这么样的一个受苦，受到这个地步。让他很绝望，他就这个时候开始反思，想他到底他是谁，然后上帝是怎么样的一位上帝。
The thing that kept him going.
那么什么事情让他能够一直坚持下去呢
？Was what he described as the fire burning within him.
是他在书中形容的是，在他心里好像有一团火燃烧。
The fire was the message that God had laid in him that he was supposed to declare.
他说的这团火就是上帝赋予他的这个信息，让他出去宣讲的这个信息。
So being called by God to any kind of place or ministry or work will in some ways involve suffering.
所以如果你要被上帝呼召到任何比如某种事工或者某种工作或者某些地方去的时候，你要知道这可能会涉及你会受苦的。
Even in places that you think should have been holy.
可能即使有时候即使是一些地方你认为应该是一个很圣洁的地方。
You know, over my 40 years of ministry, I have employed staff in the church.
我超过40年服侍在教会的服侍，我有时候会雇一些人来教会做事工。
I have also had to have difficult conversations with pastors.
有时候我会跟牧师也会有一些非常就是不舒服的一些谈话。
But what sometimes I find funny is people coming to work in church and thinking that it's going to be like heaven.
我觉得有时候所谓有点可笑的事情就是，有些人他们觉得一来教会，那就应该是一个非常圣洁的地方，像天堂一样的一个地方。
They have colleagues who will not cooperate with them.
他们在就是职场可能他们的同事不会与他们合作。
They have colleagues that will talk behind their backs.
可能有人在背后在同事里会说他们的坏话。
And they have supervisors who make life hard for them.
他们的老板可能是使事情非常对他们来说非常苛刻。
Just like any working place out there in the marketplace.
所以教会里这也会发生，就像职场的任何一个地方一样的。
You see, life when God calls is never easy.
所以我们要知道的一件事情是，生活如果是上帝呼召你以后的这个生活，也不是非常容易的。
And there will be times when God calls us while we are flowing with Him in obedience that we begin to question at the very beginning whether we did the right thing or not.
有时候上帝呼召了，我们也顺应他了，我们就跟着他一步步往前走的时候，这个时候我们心里会有时候质疑这到底是不是从他而来的呼召。
In my time as president of the Methodist Conference, There were pastors who have come to me and said, I want to resign.
当我是主持这个卫理公会的这个大会的时候，有时候牧师会来到我的这里，告诉我说，我想辞职。
It's the same thing for you if you believe that God has called you to a particular position in the company or somewhere, you know, in the working place. You believe God has called you to go there.
对于你来说可能是非常相似的事情。当上帝呼召你到公司去，或者呼召你到其他的一个工作的岗位上去的时候，你相信是上帝呼召你到那里去的。
And the pastor would come to me simply because he or she couldn't stand the working environment.
这些牧师他们来到我的面前，可能是他或者他，他们没有办法容忍他们工作的这种环境或者气氛。
It was difficult working with difficult colleagues.
对于那些很难相处的这些同事来相处来非常的困难。
But one question I always ask them, and that usually.I've never received a good answer is this.
但我无论他们是谁到我这来讲他们要辞职的事情，我都会问他们一个问题，但是我从来没有得到一个好的答案。这个问题是什么呢？
If God has called you to this place,
如果上帝呼召你到这个地方来，
has he told you to leave?
他有没有告诉你离开这个地方？
If God has called you to this place, has he told you to leave?
如果上帝呼召你到这个地方来，他有没有叫你离开这个地方？
If he hasn't, no matter what, you stay.
如果他还没有告诉你要离开这个地方的话，那不管外面发生什么事情，你得待下来。
But that kind of advice, people don't want to listen.
可是那种我提的这种建议，他们是不愿意听进去的。
And in those instances when I have given that advice, they all left.
我给他们这些建议的时候，那几个来到我面前的人，他们最后都是辞职了。
And so when we think about God's calling, we have to also mix it with a sense of realism.
所以当时我们想到神的呼召的时候，我们也应该有一定的这个要与现实主义，以现实来为基础，或者融合在现实融合在里面这个决定。
We need that dose of realism to know that all these things are real.
我们要心里要有这么一个想法，就是还是要有现实主义，就是说这一切的事情是真实的。
There are difficult people all around the world, including difficult Christians.
我们身边有很多很难相处的人，这包括很难相处的基督徒。
That's why they need pastors.
这就是为什么我们需要牧师来牧养我们。
But how is it possible, you know, in the place whereyou have pain, and then you realize that things are not rosy and dandy, and yet you're called to this place. What keeps you there?
那么，如果真正的是在现实的时候，你正在受苦，然后呢，生活周围的生活也不像我们说的这个天色常蓝花常香的这种情况的时候，那么你里面要有什么东西在你里面能支撑着你坚持下去呢？
Jeremiah stayed on because of the fire of God's message that was burning in him.
耶利米之所以能坚持下去，因为他的心内有一团火，这个火是上帝赋予他的信息，让他在燃烧，让他能够坚持下去。
How would you know that the fire is still burning?
你怎么才知道耶利米的火还在燃烧呢？
Especially when you're going through a very challenging and difficult situation with difficult people.
特别是你在正在现在正在受苦，身边有一个很大的挑战和很不容易相处的人在相处。
One good example of this we can find is in Psalm 88.
那么在诗篇八十八篇，我们能找到一个很好的例子。
Psalm 88 is a psalm that, if you read really, you get into it, is very depressing.
诗篇八十八篇，如果你要真正读进去的话，你就发现这是一个非常非常令人灰心的一个非常抑郁的一个诗篇。
It's a long song, sad song that never ended up happy.
所以好像是一个很长很长的一首歌或一个诗篇，然后呢，非常非常的悲伤，好像结局也不是太好。
But it is a song in which the psalmist is talking to God, singing to God.
可是这是一个诗篇，就是这里面诗篇的这个作者呢，是在和上帝说话，或者和向上帝唱歌。
How would you know that the fire is still burning in your heart when all other things seem to be trying to douse the fire?
那么， 当身边的所有的事情好像都想把这团火熄灭的时候，你怎么才能知道在你心里的这团火还在燃烧呢？
When you have not broken your connection with God，
怎么样发生呢？就是你和上帝之间的联系不要中断。
See Jeremiah in the midst of all his suffering， he was still praying。
你知道吗？耶利米在他经历那么样多的苦难的时候，他还是继续和上帝祷告。
His prayer was not so much about asking God for things or to remove his pain. He was just talking to God about his pain.
他当初祷告的内容呢，不是说他向上帝要求东西啊，或者说把我挪去，从这个苦难从我身边挪去，而是他在苦难中间和上帝讲述他所遭受的苦难。
He has a whole book in the Bible about it.
他在圣经里面有整个一本书是讲这个。
And so even when we are going through the most difficult times, if we are still praying,
所以即使我们生活中现在很困难
the fire,
很难的时候，我们还要祷告。
The fire will keep burning.
这个时候我们心里的那团火就继续燃烧。
We will know that we have surrendered.
我们知道我们可能顺服了，降服在神的面前。
To the enemy, when we stop praying.
当我们停止祷告的时候，其实我们就是向敌人投降了。
Now, please do not see this message as God calling you to enter full-time ministry.
所以当我们今天听这个道的时候，不要认为这个是说一定是讲的是上帝要呼召你来全职侍奉。
Or God is calling you to be a pastor or to be a missionary or a church staff.
或者上帝来呼召你作为牧师宣教士或者在教会里工作的职员。
He calls us to a place where he wants us to be.
他其实是呼召我们到一个地方成为他想要我们成为的人。
And it could be anything, anywhere.
也可能，这可能是任何事情或者任何地方。
Now I know that when I have shared this similar kind of a message elsewhere, there was a question that always keep coming up.
我在别的地方讲这个相同的道的时候，那么总是有同样的一个问题一直出现。
How do I know that this is the Lord speaking to me?
我怎么样才有办法能知道这是真的是主在跟我个人讲话呢？
How do I know that this is the Lord who the Holy Spirit who's leading me, you know, into this particular calling?
我怎么样才能知道是圣灵带领我进入这个特别的这个呼召呢？
How do I know it is the voice of the Holy Spirit?
我怎么样才能辨别这确实是圣灵的声音呢？
I think sometimes we make that more complicated when it's actually very simple.
有时候我觉得我们好像把一件很简单的事情变得很复杂了。
If you have read your Bible, if you are a Bible reading, you do your devotional daily.
如果你要读圣经的话，或者你每天都固定的有读经计划的话。
I'm sure there are many, many times when you end that time by saying, God spoke to me.
我相信有很多时候当你读完圣经的时候，那天早上你可能会想，哇，上帝今天确实和我说话了。
A particular verse or a particular thought struck you, and you sense somehow it's God telling you something.
好像当初有特别的一个经文或者是一个想法，忽然抓住你的注意力，哇，你在想，哇，这一定是上帝和我讲话了。
For us, for many of us who are perhaps too over-educated, we think it is our thoughts.
有些时候我们可能受的教育太多了，我们想的比较多，我们在想这个是一定是我们自己的想法。
But God has already spoken to you many, many times.
可是上帝已经跟你讲过讲话讲过很多很多次了。
But it's just that you've never put the two together and to realize that all those things that your thoughts and the passages that seem to jump out from the Bible and the sermons that you've heard where there's a word that spoke to you, all those things are the ways in which God has already been speaking to you.
可能有时候我们会想复杂了，其实当 很多时候我们这个脑子里的想法，或者是你读经的时候忽然有一句经文非常醒目的跳在你的眼这个眼帘里，或者是有时候在牧师讲到的时候有一个字，你好像觉得这个字对你来说特别的有印象，或者是特别感动，那么这都是上帝与我们讲话的一些方式，上帝已经和我们讲话了。
And so we hesitate.
所以我们好像有时候就不知道。
It's like someone you know very well, right?
我们就有时候会犹豫，就好像一个你很熟悉的人。
And when the person calls you and there's no ID telling you who the person was, you pick up the phone, you know it's that friend.
有时候一个电话进来，然后呢这个电话上也没有这个 ID 告诉你这个人打电话的电话号码是多少，但是你一听这个人一开始说话，你就知道这个人是谁。
It's a familiarity with the voice.
因为你对他的声音非常熟悉。
And so over time, you know, when you're walking somewhere in a busy mall and someone shouts your name and you know it's that person.
所以随着时间的推移，当你有时候在外面走路的时候，比如你在一个非常拥挤的一个购物中心走路的时候，后面有一个人叫你的名字或者什么跟你说话，你不用看他你就知道那是谁。
It's like that in our relationship with God.
那我们和神和上帝的关系也是如此。
Begin to be familiar with ways and means through which God has spoken to you and begin to see those things as God's voice speaking to you.
我们应该开始熟悉上帝做事的方法和方式，然后我们应该开始熟悉上帝跟我们讲话的方式，在我们生活中。
And then be bold to take action according to those voices or thoughts that have come to you.
那么当这些话语来到我们来临到我们的时候，或者是这些想法在我们脑子里成型的时候，你要大胆的把它做出来，走出那一步。
It's okay to be mistaken a few times.
那么你犯几次错，如果犯了错误没有关系，犯几次错误都没有关系的。
You know, sometimes when my son pick up my phone and answer the phone on my behalf, people would think it's me.
有些时候我的儿子接电话的时候，那么其他人以为在电话的那一端是我，因为我们的声音很像。
Because his voice sounds very much like mine.
因为他的声音和我的声音很像。
It's okay to be mistaken. Over time, we can refine our ability to discern the voices.
那么如果犯一些错误的话没有关系的，慢慢慢慢的我们就越来越清晰的知道这些声音是从哪儿来的，是从神来的还不是从神而来的。
And of course, listen to some objective voices as well in your life from people who really love you, who know you and care for you.
当然在寻找你的这个呼召的这个过程中，你也可以听一些比较客观的声音，一些人的声音，这些是比爱你的人，他们关心你的人的声音。
Of course, don't share what you sense is a calling of God upon your life with any Tom, Dick, and Harry.
I'm sorry.
Don't share God's calling upon your life with just anybody.
Okay. 当然了，你不需要跟所有的人，大街上的人告诉哦，上帝呼召我做这个事情。
There will be some people who will make fun of you.
有些人会笑话你的。
Speak to people who you know love you and care for you and will want the best for you.
那么你要跟谁分享你上帝对你的呼召呢？要那些你知道他们爱你，他们关心你，而且他们愿意你成为最好的自己的这些人。
Seek their counsel.
寻找他们的意见和辅导。
And of course, God doesn't call you out of nothing.
当然了，上帝不会就是凭空的然后给你一个呼召。
God calls us out of a community that we belong.
他通常是我们在我们所属的这个社区，这一群人中间，他把我们呼召出来。
Be part of a community of loving Christians.
那么你们要成为一群爱主的这种基督徒的这个社区的一员。
Like in a cell.
例如去细胞小组。
People who you know will look out for you.If they find you missing for a long time,
你知道细胞小组或者是这些社区这些成员里面，如果你要好久不去的话，他们会来寻找你，就问你到哪里去了。这些人
，people who will go out of their way to come and save you,
他们会尽他们的一切，即使有时候对他们来说不方便的时候，他们会来帮助你，来拯救你。
And I think when you take these steps and you put these boundaries around you.
you cannot go wrong.
当你走出这几步的时候，我以上说的几步的时候，然后你在你的身边画一个界限的时候，我觉得你应该不会走错道路。
So I hope as we close,
那么我结束的时候
that you do not sit down there and say, ah, very nice, lah, Bishop, but God's not going to call me.
我会想，哦，嗯，你讲得非常不错，主教，可是我不觉得上帝会来呼召我。
God calls ordinary people.
上帝呼召的是很普通的、平凡的人。
He may not necessarily call us to extraordinary circumstances.
他可能是不是要让我们去做一个好像非常宏伟的一个大事情。
He calls us to specific callings in our lives.
他会呼召我们做我们生命中的一些具体的一些呼召。
I know that for many of us over here who are especially expatriates or you know, people who are moving around in different parts of the world, we are always in transition.
我知道我们在座的有很多人是从外国外派过来的，所以呢，我们都很习惯了在世界各地经常的这样移动，所以我们好像一直是在游动的这种状态中的。
Where you're going next?
你的下一站
Is that God's calling for you?
那个是不是上帝对你的呼召？
Where you're staying now?
你现在所处的位置和地方
Is that God's calling for you?
这个是不是上帝对你的呼召？
And I trust that looking at this lesson of Jeremiah, we can be prepared and be ready and be sure when God calls.
所以希望我们今天学了耶利米这个人物以后，我们能够做好准备，我们也能够确信如果上帝的呼召临到我的时候，我知道怎么做。
Let us pray.
让我们大家一起来低头祷告。
Father, thank you. Thank you, Lord, for this time to hear your word.
天父，我们感谢你，感谢你，我们有这样的一段时间能坐在这里听你的话语。
That in the midst of the many words that I have said.
今天我讲了很多话，在这些话之中。
I pray that, Lord, we would have heard your word for us.
我的祷告是，今天我们能够听在这些话语中，能听到你要对我们讲的话。
So I pray, Lord, for my brothers and sisters here.
我为我在这里的弟兄姊妹来祷告。
Even as we all move through different seasons and phases of life.
我们现在可能在生活中的不同的时期，不同的季节。
We may be ready, Lord, to respond to your call.
我们能够就这样做好准备来回应你对我们的呼召。
And be found faithful.
然后你会认为我们是忠心的。
We pray this in Jesus' name.
我们这样祷告是奉耶稣的名。Amen.
Amen.
Well, I hope you enjoyed the service today, and thank you so much for joining us. And I know that you've been encouraged by the preaching of the word, that you know that God loves you, and He has good thoughts toward you. You can continue to follow us on our website, and our social media accounts in YouTube, Facebook, and Instagram.Or simply drop us an email to keep in touch. And here at ICS, we're a church, we're a family that's blessed to bless the community and the nations. So we hope that you were blessed today and you're really starting to think about how you can be a blessing, to your neighbors and those around you. God bless.